Hello, my name is Jared Eggleston, and I'm one of the lead developers on Castle Warriors. Castle Warriors is a roguelike auto-battler with an RTS twist added to it, and I wanted to show you guys a quick 5-minute gameplay preview of our game. Now I'll be showing you an early access dev build, and of course this is a fresh save, so I do not have anything unlocked. That means I'm only playing with the 2 starter races, Elf and Human, and there's 6 base units, so I only have 12 of the 50 unit roster unlocked right now. I only have 2 of the 5 starting warriors unlocked, so I will be going with the Elf Archdruid Allura, and of course, since it's a fresh save, we only have one map, so I'll be playing map 1. Okay, so when you start a game, you are greeted with Recruit a Mercenary, and it is super simple. You click which mercenary you want to click, or recruit, and then boom. Look at him. He is on a path to destroy the enemy castle and anything he runs into on the way. Like this goblin, for instance. And what you'll notice is when it dies, our warrior leveled up. And when she leveled up to level 2, we got a new recruit mercenary. So every time your warrior levels up, you get to recruit a new mercenary. And I will be going with... I could stack Liams. I could get a second Liam. I'm actually a big fan of Liam, especially when he gets upgraded. But I will be showing you just a more diverse comp. So I'll be selecting the Wizard Osmond. And like I said, when these units spawn, this is the auto-battler portion of the game. You recruit these minions, and they just spawn throughout the game. They constantly spawn on their spawn rate timer. Each unit has their own unique spawn rate. And their goal is to get across the map to kill the enemy castle, as you can see here on the right. And every time you level up, which we are about to level up when one of these goblins dies, we get to pick a new unit. This time I'll be picking an elf unit, so we're going to be going with the Rogue Arano. I like the Rogue Arano. I like getting a couple of Rogue Aranos, I don't need to say his class every time. Rogue does extra damage versus light units, and a lot of these fodder units that you see constantly spawning, the goblin shooters, most of the flood units are light units, so rogues are really good at cleaning those up. Okay, so this recruitment board gave us one of every unit we've seen so far. So now we get to stack. I'm a big fan of Liam, like I said. He's a good tank, he takes a lot of damage, he gives your range units some support, so I'm going to be getting a second Liam going. And boom. As you can see here, we now have 2 Liams spawning. And they're going to keep spawning throughout the rest of the game. You can even see here that we have 2 times of them spawning. So this is the auto-battler portion of the game. Your units just keep spawning on these timers and keep moving down the lane, and eventually they'll either get to the end or get pushed back. Now the other aspect of this game is the warrior abilities. Each of the warriors have a unique ability. They all do some form of crowd control effect usually, but what's important is they do damage. And when you land a killing blow on any of the enemy units with a warrior ability, it gives you +1 damage. So if you got like 10 killing blows, it's suddenly doing +10 damage. And it's a really good way to help your army as well as keeps the match pretty engaging. So I'm going to go ahead and use Polymorph here. It did 10 damage to all of those units. I'm playing on a build designed around making a trailer, so currently health bars are disabled. But normally it's a lot easier to see when a unit's about to die, so it makes it a bit easier to land these last hits. Since I don't know what the mob HP is with this build, it's a bit hard to land last hits. So I'm going to go with a third Liam. I really like getting a bunch of Liams up. Look at that, 3 Liams all spawning. They're not spawning at the same time. They're spawning based off when you click them. Those 3 just happen to be synced up well. And that is really the gist of the game. You are constantly spawning units. I want to try and show you guys a 2-star unit, so I'm going to hang around until we get one of those to show up so I can explain that. But that's really it. These units are moving down the field. Every 15 seconds, your warrior ability comes up, so you can be spamming these, trying to get the last hits. That's really fun, getting last hits. Ooh, we get to go. This is my favorite unit in the game, probably, Archerena. It's between Archerena and Squire Liam, which is funny that my favorite units are 1-star units, but they're both so good. Okay, so let me show you this real quick. This is the first boss. So every boss spawns every 2 minutes. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, all the way to 20. Bosses are powerful, unique units that only spawn once at that 2 minute, unlike the other flood units that constantly spawn on a raid. And as you can see here, they're pretty powerful. This first boss is going to do some good damage and push our army back a bit. Oh, actually, you got pulled pretty quick. I love Liam's, man. And what you noticed was that sound going off when the boss died. We got a boss reward. Every time you kill a boss, you get a reward, and when you click it, this happens. And when it's done, you'll see something pretty cool happen. Who are we going to get upgraded? Liam! Oh, I love upgraded Liam. So here is the unupgraded Liam. Oh, of course, we level up and we get 3 Liams in the shop. So as you can see here, he is Squire Plus now because he's upgraded. He's got a new portrait with the armor. And as you can see him spawning now, he looks different. And he'll have a different ability as well. He'll have a new ability unlocked, as you're about to see. Let's go, Liam. Yeah. So Liam, once upgraded, gets charged, gets him to the front line. Upgraded units, generally speaking, always get an HP boost as well as a damage boost. So they're just more powerful units, and a lot of the time, they get new abilities. Like Liam with charge. Reyna, the archer, she gets a attack speed bonus. So yeah. Okay, cool. This is what I wanted to show you guys. A 2-star unit. So, as you can see here, the Unicorn Rune is a 2-star unit. Now, how do you get 2-star units? Two ways. It requires two things, actually. One, you have to have played a 1-star unit of the same race. So we only got to see a unicorn because we got have a 1-star unit of Elfdown. So that's one of the prerequisites, is having a previous tier unit of the same race down. So if you want to see a 3-star elf, I have to pick this rune here. I have to eventually get a 3-star, I have to pick a 2-star. And of course, the other factor is your warrior level. The higher your warrior level, the higher probability you are of seeing more powerful units. So if you're level 50, you have a really good chance of seeing 2, 3, and 4-star units. If you're level 1, I'm pretty sure at level 1, at level 2, there's like a, I think it's a 1% chance to see a 2-star unit if you have a 1-star unit down. So, as you can see, like, you're constantly getting better units throughout the map. But, of course, if you don't have a elf unit played, you would never get a chance to see this. So, there he is. Unicorn is picked. And that's really the gist of the game, guys. You're constantly picking units every time you level up. You're constantly trying to secure killing blows with your units. You're killing bosses, and you're getting them upgraded. And, yeah, that's Castle Warriors, guys. I hope you like this gameplay preview. I hope you're as excited for our release as I am, and I will look forward to you guys in our next video.